What's going on? This is Pedram, and in this video, I want to talk about 10 principles to success. That's right. In order to achieve our goals, we need to have deep-seated principles, and we need to follow them in order to become successful. So I want to talk about 10 of those principles that can help you achieve your dreams, your goals, and wherever it is that you're trying to go. So what's number one? Number one is to be ready for it. Your attitude is your success. What you got to do is you got to prepare for success. You have to be ready for it, and you have to be able to recognize it once it comes your way. So the way to do that is you need preparation. You need to really understand your field, and you need to understand where it is that you're going to go in your life, in your business. So when an opportunity arises and when it comes your way, you'll be able to recognize the difference, and you'll be able to know that this is an opportunity and go after it and utilize it and be able to take full advantage of it. So be ready for success, know what it is, and your attitude, for have a good attitude towards it. Number two is to drop your ego. That's right. Number two is to drop your ego completely. Look, lots of people failed in business, in life, in a lot of different goals because they have a big ego. And you cannot really run a successful business, or you cannot really climb the ladders of life if you are too proud of yourself and if you're egotistical and you don't know yourself. So you see a lot of businesses failed just because the founder or the person was in charge was just more worried about how to build a brand and how to stand out and how to have a brand where he or she can can really feel proud of. Instead, you want to completely get rid of the ego, and you want to really truly help people within your business, and you want to help people reach a goal. And your aim should be making your prospect, your customers, your followers, you should make their life easier. You should get them to where they want to go, and you want to give them that transformation that goes from point A all the way to point B. So drop your ego, drop that second person inside you that's trying to be proud, trying to say I'm better and trying to feel I'm better than people and I know everything. Drop that and have full open-mindedness to be able to recognize and to be able to see what it is that your market, what it is that the world want, be able to see the real world. So ego has probably failed a lot of businesses, have failed a lot of different people because people are way too proud of themselves, and their ego stands in the front of their success. So that's ego. Number three is fears. So one of the things that stops men and women really going to where they want to go and to go to what they want to achieve and have what they want in life is simply fears. It stops you from going real. I think it was Napoleon Hill that said, fear is only a state of mind. Fear is not actually real, and it does not exist. It's just the way we predict things. It's just the way we think things are. But in reality, the things don't work out like that. And simply, fear is false evidence appearing real. So really, it don't exist. We could really be fearful of something just because of what happened yesterday. But yesterday don't exist anymore. Today is today. And most often, fear is just not real because we do get the result what we want. But because of fear and what's inside our head, we feel that this is going to happen again, and we think we give negative feeling to that, and we're scared that okay, that might not work and that might not go our way. But in reality, fear don't really exist. It's just false evidence appearing real. And if you manage to overcome one of your fear, which is one of the most barriers stopping lots of people getting to where they want to go. So what you got to do is you got to really be able to get rid of all your fears, and you want to tell yourself, look, it's not real. this is not going to happen. And it's just my mind thinking that way because of past experiences, which is not relevant to now, and be able to take action and be able to go to where you want to go. And another thing about fear is we all have fears. There is not completely no way that you can actually get rid of all your fears and stop them from appearing and coming to the surface. We all have them. What you got to realize about fears is fear is basically wetting yourself, and courage is to keep going. So one of the books I've read is To Feel the Fear and Do It Anyway. And that book went on to explain that we are always going to have that fear. It's just about embracing it, recognizing it, and taking action and just going to the next step and ignore our feelings and just start taking action. Now, sometimes we have to stop our fears if we are, for example, we don't want to be jumping in front of a train, or maybe we want to. Some fears are real, and we want to definitely listen to them. But some of the fears, like picking up the phone call and calling a client, or for example, talking to that person you like, you know, or going ahead with your business plan and start, all of those are not real and stops us from where we want to go. So it's definitely worth knowing fear exists in our mind, and it's just a matter of ignoring them and pushing forward and just going to the next level. So number four is visualization. Seeing is believing. So one of the things the most successful people follow when they want to get to their goal is the daily visualization or regular visualization. So what that means is you really see yourself in the place that you are in the future. So let's imagine you have already what you are after. So all your goals that you have, just imagine one of them, the most important ones. Just imagine yourself having that goal right now, and you want to regularly visualize, and you want to see it, and you want to really truly believe it. And if you visualize it long enough, you'll be able to go in a way that you get much closer to your goal. So the daily and regular visualization is absolutely key, and seeing is believing. So next is forget the past, and today is a new day. So one of the men and women biggest burden is simply we tend to focus on the past, and we don't really focus on right now, because we believe that if something happened in the past, it's going to happen again, it's going to happen right now. And the real reality of that is that past don't exist, future don't exist. All we have is right now at this moment. It does not mean what happened yesterday could happen today. It's just like I said, it's all fear, and we tend to focus on the past. If you want to succeed in life, in business, in whatever it is that you're after, your focus should be fully on the present moment, and you should believe that good thing is going to happen, and you want to completely forget the past. Even though the past has some dark times, it might be time where you failed, it might be time where you were embarrassed, it might be time where you had a lot of different fears, but reality is you want to be fully present to the moment, and you want to really forget the past and only focus on now, and only think about what could go right instead of thinking what could go wrong. And really, I am a victim of this as well. I tend to, just like everybody else, focus on the past, and you believe if it happens in the past, it's going to happen again. Where if you want to become successful, your aim should be right now and how well things can go in the future. And one of the biggest diseases we have as human being is we focus on the past too much, and is really key and critical for your success to forget about the past, and so that you can adjust on future, and you can make, and you can really solve your problems, and you can move to the future and really optimize for success and go to where you want to go. So be careful about this one. This is a killer, and it's going to stop you from where you want to go. Forget the past. Focus on what can go right, focus on the future, and it will definitely help you with where you want to go. The more you think about the past, the more you're going to be victimized of your own thoughts, and the more you're going to mess up in life, and you're going to do things that's going to mess up even your current time. And when that happens, success will become outreach and forage, and definitely you don't really want that. Number six is make the right choices. So the choices you make right now, today, will determine your success 5 to 10 years from now. So you have to make the right choices. It all starts with today. What you do today determines your success in 1, 2, 3, 4, and up to 10 years. You have to do what the right choices are. You have to have your goal at hand, and you have to know where and what it is that you're doing, and where it is that you want to go, and you want to focus on making the right choices on a regular basis, on a day-to-day basis. And if you want to go to where you are, you have to focus on those right choices and make them right every single day. If you just say, oh, it's only a day and this is not important, and I could do this from tomorrow, then this can repeat again and again and again. So the key focus and the way you want to do is you want to focus today. Today is what determines your success in 5 or 10 years from now. So really and truly, today is the big way. If you focus on today, if you take care of today, then tomorrow will be fixed and tomorrow will be better. So the decisions you make are absolutely critical to you and to your success in life in general. Okay, so number seven is problems don't exist. Problems are just signs that they are just opportunities. And I think it is in Chinese that they have problems and failures actually means opportunity. So when there is a problem, all it means is a challenge, and there means something you can improve on, and you can really become successful. And so what you want to take the word problems and change the word problems to challenge. Instead of saying I have a problem, you can say I have a challenge coming up, and that way you'll be able to deal with it better. And also know that problems are don't really exist. Is all problems, all it means is opportunity, is a challenge, and it means there's a growth, and it means it's something you need to learn about yourself. And if you learn that problem, if you find a challenge in it, and if you solve it, that means you're going to the next level, so and to become more successful. So really and truly, problems are good. When you have problems in your life, in your business, in whatever it is that you're chasing, that means you're going in the right direction. If you don't have any problems, what that means is you're not stepping on you outside your comfort zone. You're not taking enough action, and by constantly having new problems means you are moving forward in your life, and it means that you're going towards the right direction. So really, you want to change your mind about problems, and you want to stop seeing problems, and instead focus on solving them and going to the next level. And as time goes on, your mind will become stronger. You start to see problem as opportunity, and you'll be able to handle them better, and you'll be able to come with better, faster solution in quicker time. So number eight is don't underestimate yourself, fully overestimate yourself. Be sure that you're going to become successful, and really believe in yourself. So do not have doubt that, okay, this is not for me, or I'm not going to go to where I want to go in life. Really and truly know you're going to be there. You're going to arrive at your destination, and have full confidence in what it is that you're after, and fully overestimate. Be sure of yourself instead of underestimating and thinking that you might not actually get there. So don't underestimate, overestimate, be sure of where you are going. Number nine is the power of no. Learn to say no to people. Learn to speak your mind. Learn to be honest with people, and learn to say no, because no means focus. No means saying no to things that really don't get you closer to your goals. So that might be going to your friend's party, or it might be eating that junk food, you know, or it might be going going out instead of working on the business that you have. So being able to recognize and being able to say no definitely is going to help you and help you go to where you want to go. So really learn to say no, and the way you do that is you say no so you can focus. So a lot of things gonna come to your way. Stop wasting people's time and expect the same back in return. If you don't not interested about something, just say no, get it over and done with, and say no to people because you don't really want to waste their time. And also you want to say no to them because you can say yes to the things that matters to you, yes to the things that's going to get you closer to your goal and make you become successful in whatever it is that you're trying to after. So learn to say no, and it's very powerful if you learn how to do that. And finally, the most important, and one of the most important, absolutely love what you do. Look, you should be able to do what you do without getting paid. That's what I'm talking about. If you truly, if you're in a business or whatever other field you decide to go into, if you don't love it, the chances of success are going to come very slim, and you might not reach it. I think it was Steve Jobs that said, if you don't love what you do, it's going to be so hard that you're going to give up. Okay, so there are. First of all, what you do has to be something you're good at. It has to be something that you have passion for, and you have to be good at it. As Jeff Bezos put it, your passion chooses you. You don't choose your passion. So one of the ways to really become successful is to first start, first do something that you love. So first, choose something that's good for you. So pick something that you are good at. So in order, first off, choose something you're good at, choose something on your strong part, choose something that you're passionate for, and do it because you love it. If you love it, absolutely, you will make the money down the line. Now, I know this can be a little cliche line, say love what you do and the money will come, but really and truly, this is true. If you are not willing to do what you're really after, and you're willing to only do it because he was going to pay you, then you're not going to make it. You have to really love what you do, and you have to be able to do it even if you're not going to get paid for it. And really, that's going to show that you're going to have enough determination, enough courage, and you're going to have the resilience to really stick to it and make it work down the long run. And the way to do that is you got to absolutely love what you do. You have to really do something that every day you automatically going to wake up every single morning and you're going to go do the work without you trying to put your alarm and force yourself to do the work. Instead, just focus on what it is that you love and choose the thing you're passionate about, choose the thing that you're good at, and all the hard work will be out of the window, out of the door. You will become successful and you will get to your goal. So choose something what you love. Make sure what you do you enjoy, and do not waste your time with things you don't enjoy, you don't love, and you don't want to do, and you're going to go a long way in becoming successful in whatever endeavor that is that you're trying to achieve. So really, this was a 10 principle that if you follow, you dramatically increase the chances of your success. And if you follow them exactly, and if you do them, and if you implement them, and if you take action on them, you will become successful. It's just a matter of time, and not if you're going to do it or not. So it's just a matter of time of implementing and take action and making it happen. Now, this is not for everyone. I think sometimes success can be overrated, and we want to do it because we see other people do it, and we kind of want to get hyped up for it, and we just fall into this. We just get sold on something that we don't want. One of the things you got to make sure is this is really for you, and you want to do it because you want to do it, not because someone else is doing it, and not because it's a trend and you just want to do it because other people do it. Make sure it's coming from your own heart, and it's coming from your own wants and needs, and just do you, just be you, do what makes you happy, and you'll be able to increase the chances of your success. So thanks again for taking time to watch this video. If you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead, subscribe for more videos about success, life, business, and also Leave a comment below. Tell me what you think. If you have any questions, I would appreciate to answer them. Thanks again, and until next time, take care.